of objection because she wants to go check things out. All I'm focusing on right now is teaching her. When I click this, it's me communicating with her. We got that. I think she understands that. Now I need her to understand the position where I want her to be. So when she goes out, tap, 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 and then I stop, tap, neck. I'm choosing to go with taps right now, so not to overwhelm her. Seems to be working. Because I can. Good. See, I tapped that. She knows it's me. Good girl. Good girl. That's the first step. Making sure they know what the sensation means. She knows it means good girl. To kind of tune into me. Good girl. If I can get that, that's half the battle. Now I'm just going to get more specific as to position here. When I turn it on, because she looks at me.
Hey, look, no barking at that person over there.
Yeah, I think her mind's a little busy. Good girl. I'm trying to figure out this puzzle I'm presenting her with. So I'm just giving her many reps on how to turn off the pressure, what I want from her when I correct. And then I'm not going to let her go out anymore. You can notice I'm letting her go out and I'm putting the pressure on.
To teach her.
Good. I'm at held pressure now. She's taking it really well. I'm at a 6 still. Good girl. So, okay, so now she's like, I understand what to do with this pressure. Turns on. I come over here, it turns off. So now I'm going to start using the word heel right before the pressure turns on. It almost acts as if as like a warning. I'll say heel, and then it's like her motivation to turn to get to this position before the numbers turn on, before the ecollar turns on. That's how I think of it. Heel. We have to condition it. Good. We have to condition it to mean something. Heel. Heel. Good. You're going to notice very shortly I'm going to say the word heel and she's going to move back before I touch the button. Heel. Good. Heel. Good. Heel.
Another person.
Yeah, I'm very quiet when I do it because if I'm talking all the time, it makes my voice not relevant. Good girl. So I'll literally only use markers and the command word. Heel. Good girl. Starting to develop it. So once I feel like she has a very strong understanding, then I'm gonna go firmer with my corrections to stop the desire to go out in the first place. Okay? Heel. Where you can make a mistake is if you don't teach what to do with the pressure, and you go straight to firm corrections. Heel. That's where you can cause confusion and see a big nasty flip out.
It's not being very fair to the dog.
It's not being fair. So she normally barks, there's a person right there. Heel. But just because I'm expecting her to be right here, she has to split her brain. She has to think about her position. If she does bark at him, I'll correct pretty firm.
But it's so interesting how we never addressed barking at the humans. It just stops when teach a heel command.
Yeah, never did. Because it's not allowed anyway in this command. They have to be calm and focused. Now. So it's all about getting the dog to follow you. As soon as I get a moment like that where she disengages, I'm clicking on the e-collar. Good girl. She's loose right now, and that's okay. She's following me. That's the first step. following. She's used to leading, so. See? There's no communication. Where she understands exactly what you want, and you can hold her accountable, that's where you get a really well-behaved dog that you can take everywhere. Good. She's already calmer, because she was crazy when she got in here. Heel. Good. So I purposely make sure she's out of position so that I can teach her how to get back into position.